Let me see your trophy. What place is that?
First place.
First place? Hey, nice. Congrats. Okay, so what's your name?
Hi, I'm Abby Walker.
Hi, Abby. And what do you sing the most?
I sing a lot of acoustic pop songs, some Christian music thrown in, a lot of inspirational originals, and then, of course, sad music, because who doesn't love a good cry?
Yeah, that's what God's given us, to be able to feel our expression, our emotions,
yes.
The passion that He has for us is in us.
Yeah.
And we get to experience that. Do you agree?
Oh, totally. One of my favorite parts of this job is getting to heal alongside people through the songs God puts on my heart.
So do you believe music heals our mind and our hearts and even ties us together?
Yes, 100%.
Do you think music can connect us?
Can it what?
Can connect us?
I do think music can connect us, and I do think it has the power to heal. I think their music is so beautiful. I don't know how to say it. Music is so beautifully emotive in a way that sometimes I can't get to by myself. And I think a lot of people struggle with that. So I feel like it brings us together to feel all together.
Awesome.
Good afternoon, Oakfest and Prescott, Arizona. We frequently get the question when we come across people, what is an Arizona Ranger? Are you like the Texas Rangers? Well, one answer is no, we don't get paid, they do, and they have Chuck Norris. At any rate, we are an all-volunteer law enforcement auxiliary. We can work with any law enforcement agency anywhere within the state of Arizona, whether it's federal, state, local, tribal, does not matter. In addition, we provide security services for public events, private events on request. And I will put a little plug in, we're always recruiting. And we do have a recruiting booth on Gurley. And we're proud to serve Arizona. We are all volunteers again. So thank you very much and be safe.
I'm the soon-to-be outgoing marketing director for Gettles High Desert Mechanical, Heating, Air Conditioning, and Plumbing. We are privileged to be a major sponsor of this year's Hope Fest Arizona event. I am going to put on my my middle school administrator assembly hat for a minute. Let's get ready to rumble!
We are Chris and Greg Venhouse. We are the owners of Amish Home Decor in Prescott Valley. Right down there on Glassford and 69. If you haven't been there, come by and see us. We've got some beautiful furniture. Been there about 2.5 years. We also are the founders of our nonprofit called Heartland Ranch. Heartland Ranch will be a ranch for kids that have been trafficked. We know that this is an awful, awful epidemic that's going on, and we felt like we need to do something about it. So we are, we've started this nonprofit. Our tagline is Hope for Little Hearts. We know that the only hope for these kids is Jesus. So this will be a faith-based ranch for kids that have been trafficked.
So this is my wife, Carrie, and I'm Rodney. We are pastors at a ministry in Phoenix called Identifreed, and we rescue women from trafficking. And I play in a band that's a Christian hard rock metal band called Deep as Bones. Deep as Bones. And you can find us everywhere. So we're going to do a little worship today. We're not going to do any rock and roll, unfortunately. But I love praising the Lord. How about you guys? You guys love playing? I do. So we're going to lift him up today. We're going to do a little bit of prophetic and spiritual lifting up of our souls to God today. And just
let's all stand to our feet. Let's worship the God who saved us. Amen.
Working all things about Hope Fest and why we're here. To end with the sponsor thank yous, I want to give a shout out to Lamb Chevrolet, which was the very first sponsor to step a toe across the stand when we first started this thing 12 years ago. And then Yavapai Bottle Gas, who's not here as well. Back in 2012, we were all a lot younger. This year, I hit my 25th recovery birthday. I was hit with something hard and honest when that happened. 25 years, that's a big deal. I have stood here on this stage every year for Hope Fest. And many times I have said, I'm a grateful believer in Jesus Christ. I believe in miracles because I am one. But really, God tugged on my heart and he says, you know what, you need to get a little bit more real. Because when people say, I believe, they can believe in anything. And I believe in Jesus Christ. So what does that mean? So what does it look like? And how can we quantify what those miracles are? Especially in today, with families having so many challenges. My journey, for example, you might think, well, gosh, she's an old lady now. What does she have to offer? Well, first of all, our generation had the best music, the 60s and the 70s, yes. And we were the most rebellious of any generation. My journey, I don't have to get into all the details and all the gore. I can tell you, I hit the end of my messed up life that I found myself in when I surrendered my stubborn rebellion, my self-protection, my addiction to drugs, the pain of being a sexual assault survivor, the heartache of adultery, my fear of being abandoned, and my need to control things and the people within my life through codependency. Now, my recovery journey might not be like yours, but that's the point. We all have our own. We all have our own recovery journey. And whether we're committed to that journey or trying to find answers and solutions, we're still on the road. I learned this universal fact. I'm not in control of anything. Nothing. There's a saying, your ministry is found where you've been broken. Your testimony is found where you've been restored. Look in recovery. God called David and me, my husband, to create Hope Fest. And the very first Hope Fest, Pastor John Baker, the founder of Celebrate Recovery, was here with us. And his son Johnny. They came to the very first Hope Fest, and I will always cherish his counsel. And right over there, where those people are standing by that sign, Pastor John Baker surrounded my team and held me in his arms and said, "You done good, girl. I've never imagined Celebrate Recovery going to the streets. This is so cool." And on that day, most of the people didn't know who Pastor John Baker was, the founder of Celebrate Recovery. He stood over there, and it was raining that day, if anybody was here. Well, when he started baptizing people, the rain stopped. And after the 15th person was baptized, and he was at the end of the line, guess what? The rain started again. It was a cleansing. Heaven is where Pastor John Baker lives now. And so we appreciate his story as part of the Hope Fest. Or if you take the loss of my two sons. In 2017, Army Staff Sergeant Travis James Solinsky. Or in 2018, Army Staff Sergeant Brandon Joseph Solinsky. There's a bee bothering me. David and I could have collapsed with paralyzing heartache and grief, but instead, God showed us how to dig deeper into our Celebrate Recovery tools and lessons and take the time we needed to sit with Jesus. We were transparent about our story and about our pain and about our walk. But we called on our incredible community and let them know where we were at, that we were still wanting to do Hope Fest, but we needed a ton of help. We were gonna laugh, we were gonna cry, but we were gonna do it together because we're community.
So if he wanted his will to happen on earth as it is in heaven, that means it's not always happening all the time. He's given us the responsibility. So that's the one thing that he's kind of like shown me, like when he poured out his nature and his character and my value and my worth in my heart in that moment, it was like he's given me a responsibility in the earth. Like I didn't know religion. I didn't know do a bunch of things so that I can become. He showed me that I was accepted and completely in him, in perfect seamless union with him face to face. In my dirt, in my most dirtiest moment, you know? So he demonstrated his love towards us that while we were sinners, Christ died for us. So there's nothing that we could do to earn it. There's nothing that we could do to attain it. And sometimes we forget that, man. We have an encounter with the Lord and we give our lives to Jesus and we go to church and we try to, you know, clean up our act and stuff. And sometimes the enemy's voice gets in there, man, and it's really blocking us from experiencing intimacy with God. He wants us to have a tender heart towards him. He wants us to wake up and actually love ourselves, you know? Like, he who knew no sin became sin so that you could become the righteousness of God. We're not just lowly worms just barely making it in. It's not just pray a prayer to get to heaven. Like, as he is, so are we in the earth. Like, you are created in the exact image and likeness of God. That's the good news. That's the gospel. We're not just sinners saved by grace, just barely making it in. He's made you a son. You are daughter. You are royalty, and he has given you power and dominion over the earth. In Genesis, in Psalms, he's made you rulers over the works of his hands. So I just believe that. I'm foolish enough to believe. It sounds too good to be true, guys. But the Lord wants you to know that there's nothing that you could do to make him love you any more than he loves you right now. There's nothing that you could do to make yourself any more righteous than you are exactly right now as you are, because he gave you his righteousness. Now we can have boldness when we come before him. Now we're not just like, just barely scraping by, just barely surviving, making it in, dragging ourselves into a Sunday service. But now it's a celebration where we're exuberated with excitement and we're captivated by the love of Jesus. If we're not captivated by the love of Jesus, absolutely 100%, we are deceived. And that's okay. That's okay. There's a level of not knowing him until we see him. Like, because if he stepped into this place right now, this place would look a lot different than it does right now, right? When we were worshiping before, this, you know what I'm saying? Like, he inhabits the praises of his people. He lives inside of your praises. So we get to engage. Everybody's in the game. Each joint supplies. Every voice matters. So the only way that I know, man, is like Jesus said to go and heal the sick, go cast down demons, go raise the dead. So I don't know anything else. I didn't have religion to talk me out of it. I didn't have the accusing voice to tell me you're not good enough, you're not qualified to do that. I just started doing it. So I started seeing miracles. I started seeing people with 13 back surgeries healed in one touch. The Lord wants to do it. He's not, we're not waiting around for God to do anything. He did something on the cross, on the death, burial, resurrection, and ascension and enthronement 2,000 years ago. He seated down. He said, you're the salt of the earth. You're the light of the world. This is, look, we get a part to play in this, man. We're not just bystanders sitting around waiting for the wedding pickup. The earth is groaning and awaiting in the revealing of the sons of God. The devil knows who you are. God knows who you are. We just don't have a clue yet. Woo! Let's give it up for everybody that had a part to play in this place, man. This is awesome. It's such an honor and a privilege to be here. Thank you so much for all your hearts and your warm welcome, your hospitality. And I'm here with, my name is Anthony Santana. I'm here with my best friend, Paul Grassi. And we're going to share our lives. We're going to share our lives through music and through just testimony. So I'm going to play this song. It's called Your Eyes. It's a cover song, but it's my own little twist.
Something was lacking. Now my mom survived. My mom, by the grace of God, survived as she met Jesus, right? And so she became a believer and a follower of Jesus. So I'm at home with my father in this chaotic environment. My mom got saved, had salvation, received salvation. And then on the weekend, she's taking me to church. And then on the weekdays, I'm living reckless. You know what I mean? And she's trying to pour out everything she can for me. My father, at a certain point, he died in a fire, and I was there. And this was another thing, another attack by the enemy on my heart as a child, like you weren't good enough to save him. You know, there was this overall theme that the enemy would try to echo over me, is that I'm not enough, that I'm not good enough, right? That condemnation, that voice, right? It would just echo and echo over me through most of my life. So what do, right? What do? You try to comfort yourself. I don't know about you, but for me, I took a lot of things in. A lot of people spoke about it today. about the comforts of the world, the comforts of life, drugs, alcohol, sex, anything like that. I would just pour into myself, money, clothes, whatever it took. You know, you could use anything too much. Anything can be a crutch when you put it in the way of God, right? Anything. So, you know, we could work too much. We could be working. We could be just doing things that just doesn't make sense to the Lord, right? Because it says, trust the Lord with all your heart. Lean not on your own understanding. Acknowledge Him and He'll make your path. He'll direct you. So life starts to happen for me. I become an adult. And I don't even know how I graduated high school. I start committing crimes. You know, that was right there. I had no, like, really, like, value system to guide my life. So I do crimes. I go to jail. I'm a drug addict. You wouldn't, like, if you met me, you wouldn't allow me into your house. You wouldn't allow me by your pet. You know what I mean? Like, it was bad. So I continue on this lifestyle. I go to prison for a bunch of time. I have over 10 years of my life is spent behind, behind bars. And it was lonely. It was lonely. And I had to learn how to behave a certain way in prison, which I hated myself. And that was one of the things that really started to happen. That not feeling enough caused this thing inside me to hate me, to really despise me, but to use things to cover it up. Never to be able to express, to say, wow, I really don't like me, right? And while I was in prison, you know, playing cards on the tier, I get bored. I'm like, maybe I should sign up for NA or AA and see what goes on. You know, maybe it will look good for parole. You know what I mean? Because I've not gotten parole a bunch of times. So I go down. I'm going to this AA NA thing, and these people are coming in, and they're bringing in this message. Right? And at first I'm like, whatever. I just wanted to make it look good. I'm losing on the poker table. You know what I mean? I'll just hang out down here. But I continue to go. And at some point in time, I hear something they said, where they said, the message is hope and the promise is freedom.
Kind of jump gears and just give you a little bit of background for those of you that do know me. You know me as Donut, right? All right, there we go. Those of you who don't know, as they were saying earlier, the survivor of the Granite Mountain Hotshots, the tragedy in 2013, I lost 19 of my brothers, and it was just detrimental to my life. I was in complete shock, suffering from alcoholism, PTSD, depression, anxiety, suicidal ideation. That all this crippling weight that seemed impossible to find a way out from, right? And I think anyone here that's listening can relate to a moment in their life that just, it felt impossible. It felt impossible to find relief. It felt impossible to find change. And I had known Christ at a young age and walked away and was distant. And the way it was described to me is like playing baseball. I never grew up playing baseball, so I didn't know much, but what I did know is that I was kind of in the nosebleeds. Like, I wasn't even playing ball. I was just way out there, but I was still in the ball field. And as I tried everything, right? I tried alcohol, I tried opiates, I tried women, I tried anger, I tried all these different things to try and fill this void in my heart that was impossible. And I kept having this pastor, some of you may actually know him, he's pretty annoying, but he's a rad guy. His name's Bob Hoy, he's from the Heights Church, right? I love Heights Church, I love our community churches too. And he kept trying to meet with me. He was like, hey, let's get together. And I'm like, all right, let's just give this guy a shot, right? He'll stop calling me, he'll stop bothering me, and I'll have to hear from him. And I ended up grabbing coffee with him. And I remember being loved in a way that I haven't been loved in years. And he was sharing the gospel with me, and he was sharing his experience. And I remember telling him all these mistakes that I had made, everything that I had done bad in my life. And he kind of just looked at me and was like, well, that's dumb. And I remember thinking, this is the kind of man that can help me walk through this. And that's when the beginning of my relationship with Christ happened. And I remember praying to God on this square, one block up, to never have to drink again. And I remember, thank you, I remember going to dinner, and I made it through a dinner without a drink. and it was St. Patrick's Day, and that was my holiday. And I get in my truck, and I remember I just started crying because for the first time, I didn't have to use a substance to feel normal.
Thank y'all, everyone. I'm so happy to be here. I'd like to thank Jaylen and her team, amazing team, for inviting us to this event. I would like to let everybody know that we have North Arizona VA Medical Center just down the road here, okay? We are here for our veterans. And just to know how much we span over 65,000 square miles here in Northern Arizona, all right? And we have 12 strategic facilities. We have the medical center here in Prescott, of course, and we have 5 community-based outpatient clinics and 6 rural health clinics. So we're like spread all out here in Northern Arizona. We provide a wide range of services from mental health to primary care, and we have specialty care. A lot of people don't realize we have dental, optometry, cardiology, and a lot more. Our duty and honor to serve those who served our country. And we're here to let you know how well we kind of like to brag and how well we serve. We received 2 5-star ratings, both compared to the community and in the VA world. And so to let y'all know how rare that is, there's only like 65 facilities throughout the United States to get both in 5-star facilities. So if you want to know what kind of care you get here in Prescott, that lets you know what kind of care our VA serves you, the veterans. Yeah. There's many.
Inspired, I was praying one morning in my studio, and I was thinking about the thief on the cross, and you know what he might have been thinking while he was contemplating his last few minutes on earth. It's called Remember Me. It goes like this.
Remember me. when you come into your kingdom, remember me. When you set the captives free, remember me. I'm just a liar and a thief, a sinner who's in need. Remember me when I've walked away, when I've lost my way, when I've gone astray. Bring me back to the place I belong, to a place called heaven, in a place called home. Remember me when you come into your kingdom. Remember me when you set the captives free. Remember me. I'm just a liar and a thief, a sinner who's in need. Thank you.
Hey guys, how you doing? I wanna start it over. I wanna start again. I want a new beginning, one without an end. I feel it inside, calling out to me. It's a voice that whispers my name. It's a kiss without any shame. Something beautiful, yeah, yeah. Like a song that stirs in my head. Singing love will take us where. Something beautiful. I heard it in the silence. Seen it on a face. I felt it in the long eye. Like a sweet embrace. I know this is true. It's calling out to me. It's a voice that whispers my name. It's a kiss without any shame. Something beautiful, yeah, yeah. Like a song that stirs in my head. Singing love will take us where. Something beautiful.
Something beautiful.
velvet run. It's not the way it was. I swim upstream just to find.